Today is the 1 year anniversary of the first video in this project series. The first time I showed the Dynamite 2800 on camera was September 2nd, 2019. I'd purchased it 6 years prior at an auction, and it was pretty much a basket case. Nobody even bid against me. And today we're gonna run it for the first time. Hey, it's Pete. Welcome back to the workshop. You know, Mark Twain is credited with saying,
"Giving up smoking's the easiest thing in the world. I should know. I've done it thousands of times."
And similarly, starting a new project is easy. All the excitement of a new idea is highly motivating. It's when the project stretches on and you start to lose interest in it that it can be difficult to continue. That's one of the primary reasons I started this channel. In order to keep turning out videos, I have to keep working on projects that I otherwise might have lost interest in. And while this channel is a motivation source for me, I hope that it can be motivating for you and maybe keep you moving on a project that you may have lost interest in. So if you're a fellow tinkerer, please click that subscribe button. It really helps the channel out. Because I'll tell you, nothing feels better than finishing a project. And that's where we are today. The DM2800 Centroid Acorn Retrofit is up and running, and today it's going to make its first chips. Before I share that footage with you, though, I'm going to go back and show you a few of the things I had to finish this past week to get the machine up and running. First off, the Y-axis stepper motor had to be wired up. I got the machine turned around and was finally able to replace the previous connector with the new Deutsch connector. Next on the agenda, the home switches for the X and Y axis had to be mounted. Prior to mounting them, I wanted to clean them up a bit. I just soaked them down with some WD-40 and did a bit of scrubbing to get off the caked on grease. These are the last few parts of the machine that need to be cleaned. It's hard to believe that at one point the entire machine was covered in this stuff. I'll be sharing those before and after pictures a little bit later. Once all the switches were mounted, I could click the home button and see the machine do something on its own for the very first time. I did a bit of jogging the machine around and discovered the Y-axis was going the wrong way. I could have inverted this in the Centroid CNC12 setup, and in hindsight, I probably should have, but none of the other axes were inverted, so I decided I would just swap the polarity on one of the coils in the stepper motor. And that would have been fine, but I was moving too fast. I didn't think to pull the wires all the way out of the rear seal, so I had to start over. So anyways, that was a quick fix, more aggravating than anything really. I ended up ordering an inexpensive vise and clamp set since I didn't really have anything that would fit this machine. The T-slots in this table are 3/8 of an inch, and that's even smaller than the little X2 mill uses. I know these are cheap, but I think they could have done a bit nicer job modifying this rack to fit the smaller hardware. The mill uses BT30 tool holders, and this particular holder uses ER11 collets. That'll get me up to a 1/4 inch tooling. I also have some ER32 holders, which will let me use the larger cutters. For this initial cut, I just did some manual jogging into an old aluminum box. So far, so good. Next, I put a piece of aluminum in the vise and did my first tool height offset on this machine. I used the Centroid Intercon to create a quick little program. I had my spindle speed too slow on this run, but otherwise it worked well. The actual problem was that the spindle wasn't set to the same range that CNC 12 was expecting. So finally, I decided to do something a bit more ambitious. I designed a simple part with a few features in Fusion 360, then used the adaptive clearing roughing strategy to generate a toolpath and exported it with the Centroid post-processor. This could have been a bit more aggressive, but you know, baby steps. So overall, I think some pretty good results for the first time this machine cut metal in who knows how long. Now let me pop up those before and after pictures I promised. Over the months ahead, there will be numerous tweaks to be done. The DROs need to be fine-tuned. The automatic lubricator needs to be wired up and plumbed. I'd like to replicate some of the original chip guards that were on the machine, so if you happen to have one of these Dynamite 2800s and you'd be willing to take some measurements for me, I'd really appreciate that. Contact information is down on our About page. Once that's done, I'd like to add the flood coolant, and then the big project, I'd like to build some sort of automatic tool changer. I've got that Centroid Ether 1616 board just sitting there waiting to be used. Years ago, I did several AHA retrofits as well as a Mach 3 retrofit. So this is the first time I'm using the Centroid Acorn system. It's going to be an interesting learning process. So that's it. If you're new here and you want to see how this project began, click that link to the left and I'll start you at day one. Otherwise, consider clicking that subscribe button and checking out some of the other projects we've got going on.